And it's IQQ with your review of the Acer T231H Multi-Touch Monitor. This monitor sports a brightness of 300 nits, contrast of 80,000, 2 milliseconds refresh rate from grey to grey, and it goes 160 degree viewing angle vertically and horizontally. Okay, let's quickly go over the T231H outlook. There is no buttons at the side here, as you can see, nothing. Then at the top, there are some configuration and adjustment buttons at the bottom here. The two small plastic legs in the front. There is a large leg at the back for you to tilt the LCD over so you can use it as a multi-touch monitor. So this is the back of the monitor. As you can see, there's some mounts here and a large adjustable leg so you can tilt it back and turn it into a touchscreen. There are input devices here, which I'll show you later. So just let me demonstrate how the kick leg works. It's just... theoretically, you're supposed to just push it down, but there's a lot of resistance, so just like so. There we go. And up again. Ta-da. So here are the inputs for the various devices: USB, VGA, DVI, HDMI, audio for the speakers, and across the power. And down here are the adjustment buttons for brightness, contrast, and so forth. Okay, now I'm going to configure the 231H as a multi-touch monitor. And although it did not say this in the manual, you're supposed to plug in the USB cord into your PC so it can be identified as a touchscreen monitor. Otherwise, you can fool around all you want and it will not work. And let me, wrong settings. You have to go to tablet PC settings in the control panel. And we'll just move this into a more clearer zone. Gonna collaborate it. So let's see if this really works. To provide and touch the crosshair. So I've calibrated the screen, so let's see if this works or not. Try something a little bit intricate. Let's see. That's not. Okay, that looks good. That's very interesting. I think it can. I'm not actually touching it, but. You observe, I'm hovering my hand just above. I've not touched it yet. And voila. That's quite sensitive. And just hovering my hand above it. Oops, now I touched it. Or it's not so easy to replicate, but as you can see, I was just touching it. And I'm just floating my hand right above it. And it's tracking just like that. So. Best to keep your hands off it when you're using it. There we go. That was quite nice actually for 22 inches. So just mess around with this. Okay, that's interesting. So it seems to be pretty sensitive and fairly accurate. I think if you calibrate it more and you're very accurate in your calibration, you should be able to get a screen to screen, edge to edge touch sensitivity. Okay, this is just a test to test the T231H's image quality and of course the speakers. So we'll be testing it with the Legends of the Guardian. Legend of the Guardian is a 1080p, as you can see. QuickTime trailer. So here we go. Preview looks nice. So this is looks very promising. Yes, I was actually doing several takes, so don't get excited. This is not all perfect one take situation. Okay, as you can see, it's quite nice. So we're gonna just test the zoom. Can we control where we're zooming? Yes, there's actually panning for the zoom. Zoom out. Zoom in. Zoom in. Oh, that is beautiful. And zoom out. So now we're going to test the volume level. If I'm not mistaken, this LCD has two 1.5 watt speakers. So we'll see how it goes. So you can hear there's some distortion at the higher volumes. There we go. Let's try a music video. So let's see. Hit back. That's Wonder Woman. Okay. Try the speakers on the music video and see how it sounds. Sound too bad. And there we go. Take note that this is all on stock settings. I have not actually calibrated or optimized. I haven't optimized the LCD, so this is just straight out of box quality. Now I'm a bit worried about multifunctional LCD monitors. I have a lot of problems with the D241H, which seems to have given me a lot of issues, and I think maybe they have fixed it with a firmware update, although I'm not too sure about that. But the T231H, on the other hand, it was working flawlessly. The touch screen capability is plug and play. Slap in the USB into the monitor, slap in the USB in the PC, and you're good to go. The touch screen itself is very sensitive and responsive. And of course, the build quality is very high. And when it comes to picture quality, as you can see here, it is sharp, it is vibrant, and it has a very high refresh rate, so there's no ghosting effects. So if I was to recommend this LCD to anyone, I would recommend it to people who have 2-year-old LCDs, because the jump from there to here, the upgrade is pretty rewarding, as you can tell. If you were to buy a new LCD for watching TV shows, or to act as a multimedia, to be precise, monitor, for, like I said, TV or HD content, then I would recommend this, because it really does have a very nice screen. Another thing I would recommend it for people who want to use it as a touch screen, because of course this is the main selling point of this is its touch screen capability. If you turn on the Windows 7's on-screen keyboard, you practically can be hands-free, no mouse, no keyboard, you just touch the monitor with your fingers and that's it. So all those little kids would be pretty happy. If you were just to buy it for a gaming monitor, I would recommend maybe not to, because it might be a bit expensive. There's a lot of other Acer LCDs out there which has similar specs but without the touchscreen features, which will suit you just fine. And that's about it. I think for me, I would really would stand by this LCD. It is quite a good quality one, and I do appreciate Acer Malaysia from sending it to me and for allowing me to review it. So this is IKQ signing off.